Right. I'm Nate Mello, and we're here at my studio in the Washington, D.C. area. And today we have a really cool project. I'm acting not as a guitarist, not as a producer, as you guys might know me, but as a recording engineer for our man, Charles Augustine, who's back now tracking drums here, fresh from Costa Rica, where he was tracking a very cool project we're going to talk about today. So Charles, welcome back to the U.S. And tell us a little bit, what is this project about? And I understand it has a theme to it.
Well, the project itself is called Clockwork in Action, which is a one-man band I started almost 2 years ago now. And basically, I came from Costa Rica. I wasn't born there, but I moved there 4 years ago, right when I picked up guitar, when I really started falling in love with music. And what happened was, there was no real contemporary music scene for students where in the region that I was in. So I couldn't really find a band or have a band at school. My school didn't even have a music program. So Clockwork in Action pretty much came from me having to go out and make music by myself. And it really taught me a sense of independence that I now am very grateful for. And this album, I did my first album last summer, and it was called Sometimes Smiling is the Only Way to Go. And this one is called Hymn of Orion. And basically, this album is more... The last one was an EP. This is a full length, 63 minutes exactly. And it's about finding harmony. That's what it is. And it's basically a big puzzle of anagrams that you can figure out. And there's a message in it. And maybe I'll tell the message to some people personally, but... Really, I want it to be up to you to just listen to it and see if you can dwell about the meaning yourself.
Wow, that sounds really interesting. And it reminds me of some of the records that you used to have in the past, which were called like concept albums or like a suite in a classical. I've heard the piece, and it has all these movements to it, which is very, very interesting. They all intertwine with each other. And they're also very arranged, which is it's just a very elaborate and very demanding thing to do on such a magnitude. And why actually did you decide to go with this type of format?
Well, as I probably haven't mentioned before, the entire album is one song, like a suite or something like that. So basically what you have is you have a prelude, five sections, and a finale. So in total there are seven sections. And basically, in the prelude, you have all these musical concepts being shown to you with different instruments, more of an orchestral kind of fashion. And then you have all these different movements in parts 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then in the finale, you have a restatement of all of those concepts, only with more of a metal twist, but still more symphonic. And how this works is actually, since the album is about finding harmony, and the best explanation for harmony is a circle, a circle. And for that reason, how I did this one song, it ends exactly how it starts. So that last note that you'll hear on the album is the first note that you'll hear. So in a sense, if you were to go on your iTunes and click repeat and just listen to that album, eventually it will just restart. And from that, it really hits home the idea of harmony. And if you get it, which you probably won't understand the concept first time you hear it, probably you may have to listen to it a couple of times, but it's one of those things that's psychologically engineered to make you understand it. And when it hits, it's going to be very rewarding for you.
Exactly. It reminds you of natural cycles of ebb and flow, cycles of the seasons. It's a very organic, perhaps even cosmic kind of concept that underlies much of life. Now, what are some of... I noticed there was a tremendous amount of variety, and I was wondering about some of the influences that you've had that have manifested in this particular project.
Well, the influence of finding harmony, because I have a philosophy of my own in which that harmony... I mean, it's called original or not, but harmony is the secret to life. It's not being at the top all the time. It's not about being at the bottom all the time. It's about finding that middle place or, wherever you belong in society, or in, whatever you might be doing, whatever career you have, just to find that place, that resting place where you can function peacefully. And influences musically, Bands that come to mind, there's a band that released an album a couple years ago, a pretty new band called Orange Tulip Conspiracy. Another influence would be System of a Down. One of my biggest influences, Dream Theater. Another one would be, let me think, a band, the Radiohead, of course. Radiohead, one of my favorite bands. And as well, probably Coheed and Cambria a little bit. Definitely Coheed and Cambria. And probably some others. Oh, there's another one. One last one that really stuck to me. It was a band I found not too long ago when I bought a Roland amp, and I was looking it up online, and I found this little demo video of a band called Young Legionnaire that was using this amp, and I love their sound. It was like a real like British rock kind of thing mixed with American kind of stuff, and they're just a trio, a rock trio, and I really love their sound, and there's definitely an influence of that in like the rock concepts of this album.
Wow. And how about the drum sound? And I was wondering about that because it's a very... In fact, Charles is playing the drums, and it's an hour and what, an hour? And
3 minutes.
An hour and 3 minutes. Not everything has drums, but a lot of it has. So it's a tremendously challenging piece of music because it's many styles, many time signatures that change. And it will be quite a treat, even if just on the drumming aspect. But of course, he plays guitar, keyboards. So there's even a part where there's funk, sort of like 70s style. And I kind of jumped off my chair when I listened because it's so authentic. It's really cool. Very, very well done. And it's like a time capsule. All of a sudden, you go there, you have the groove. And I mean, it's really happening. So yeah, so what about the drum sound?
The drum sound, what I did was when I recorded my instrumentation with guitars and keyboards and bass, I EQ'd it where I had a little bit of higher amplitude and middle frequencies. And what I want the drums, because drums is like, you know, that's the foundation of it, that's like what drives the music, I want that to surround it. So I want all the really high notes, like the high ends and the low ends, to kind of just kind of surround the music, once again, in like a kind of sphere, like a circle kind of thing to go with the overall theme finding.
Great. That's very, very, very well thought out. It's very interesting to see the depth of the concept behind the whole musical event. So to that effect, we're here. So we're using a kind of an old school, the best of the old school. In other words, we're using the best mic pre's, the best microphones that we can buy. And we have Neumann M149, R84s. We have the whole customized SM57s. And we have a 70s mic pre's. We have a Buzz Audio from New Zealand has a two-channel mic pre that's fantastic. I would advise you guys check that out. I endorse that one because of a reason. It's fantastic. And so we're going for it, like really acoustic tracking drums the real way. Real drums played by fantastic, not just real, but fantastic drummer right here. And I would like to ask Charles about the release date and vision for the project and where you guys will be able to get it.
Well, basically, as I said before, I had my first album last summer, and basically what I did was, with the proceeds from this album, I made a little studio in Costa Rica in my town because there was nothing like that. And basically, I would take another artist and I would kind of produce for them the same way that I would for myself. You know, just indie artists, you know, acoustic guitar and singing, or I had one rock band come in, one more of a Latino kind of like reggaeton kind of guy, and it gave me a lot of experience. And that's why I think my album is going to sound so fantastic, because I've had all this exposure to all these different kinds of music from other people. And the release date is going to be on July 7th, which is, yeah, right now we're on, I think, the 3rd of the 2nd. We're on the 2nd of July, so only, or no, 3rd of July
yeah,
now.
Third, yes.
On 3rd of July now, so it's only 4 days away from today. And this album is going to be promotional, as in, basically, the first album, to me, it was a debut album, so it was basically a statement saying that, yes, Clockwork Connection is for real. I do want to make music. I do want to have an audience, I do want to do this. And that was basically my way of saying, okay, yeah, here I am. But now, I'm stepping back, writing something much more grand, and basically this is more of the, okay, let me show you really what I can come up with. That's why I'm using all these different styles, all these different concepts to really see, just to show how dynamic of a musician I can be, because I try not to limit myself, and I think I'm doing a very good job with that. And like I said, promotional, so you can find it on your SoundCloud or your YouTube, Grooveshark, maybe Spotify, because I know that's something popular nowadays. And the thing is, I'm going to Berklee College of Music this summer for the 5-week performance program. And there, that's where I'm going to actually order and get my physical copies. I'm going to be handing them out to close friends and professors there at Berklee, because from there, since so many people from around the world go to Berklee, if you distribute it there and then they all kind of diverge and kind of go out back to their respective countries, boom, my music goes all over the world, not just on the internet, but physically. And I think that's far more important, because there's so much music all over the world on the internet, but you just never find it because you'll never see it in the store, it never catches your eye. So when you have the physical thing in the country, it really does make a big difference. So once again, July 7th. July 7th is when you can hear it. Look for Clockwork in Action on Facebook. That's one of the probably easiest ways. I'm on Facebook constantly, always updating. If you want to know what's up, Clockwork in Action on Facebook.
And speaking of the international recording scene and Charles' studio that he built in Costa Rica, we had some power outages in the area because of the storm, and I had a friend of mine who's a award-winning mastering engineer. He was staying here because his house was out of power, so he came to the studio to do some mixing, and we were talking about, first of all, he noticed Charles' drumming right away because it was in the lower level, and the drums bleached right a little bit. And then later we were talking about the quality. I was telling him the quality that Charles got in his studio is quite noticeable, because it reminds you of the quality you used to get, and you can still get in some studios today, but which was fairly common for major label releases up to the 1980s, before the big studios, many of them started closing, and because of after the crisis and the change in the music industry, not being able to support so many studios. But Charles got that kind of legendary 70s, 60s sound from mixing, from a number of recording techniques, which is very knowledgeable. He really knows his tracking, which is very interesting. Charles is just, he didn't live through that era, but he learned the best from that era. And so you'll be hearing the quality in this project that is kind of unheard of today, unless you spend, as we say, a ton of money. You go to a studio in LA or New York, and then you start shelling out the bills, But here we shell out the knowledge and the intelligence, as instead of the dollar signs, which is another way. It takes a tremendous amount of the study and experience to do that. So I'd like to thank our man Charles Augustine here from Clockwork in Action, and we look forward to have you guys check out the release very, very soon. Thanks.